press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello everyone. In the last class, we had discussed about the diversity, biodiversity, their definition, and also we had discussed about the basis of classification. So what are the basis of classification? They are, one is the presence or absence of nucleus as well as the organelles, the cell organelles, whether they are present or absent in the cell, right? Because the nuclear envelope as well as the membrane around the organelles will be not formed in some cells, some primitive cells. They are prokaryotic cells. Whereas the eukaryotic cell, the nuclear membrane will be present as well as the cell organelles will be present, right? So here, one is presence or absence of nucleus and other organelles, and the unicellular and multicellular organisms. So based on the unicellular or multicellular organisms, and also the mode of nutrition, whether the organism is autotrophic, like it prepare its own food, or else the heterotrophic. In the heterotrophic, again there are different types like saprophytic, parasitic and holozoic, right? And also the level of organization, whether the organism belongs to the cellular level, tissue level, organ level or organ system level of organization. So here, in the level of organization, due to the gradual changes in an organism, as the organisms become more complex, the multicellular organisms become more complex, their body design will change, right? And they will have a specific organs, okay, specialized organs to perform specific functions or different functions, right? So we had discussed about the basis of classification, and today let us discuss about the relationship between classification and evolution. So how evolution is related to the classification, let us discuss now. Before that, what is classification? So here, classification, it is the systematic method of arranging organisms into different groups and subgroups based on their similarities and dissimilarities. So here, the similarities, right? The similarities and dissimilarities are the characters of an organism. So an organism will have some characters, and if you compare an organism with another one, so you will find some similarities with both of them and some dissimilarities. So based on that, the classification is done. That is, the grouping of organisms is done. And this group can be again subgrouped. Okay? Now, coming to the evolution. What is evolution? Evolution, it is the formation of new species due to the change in specific characters of several generations of living organism as a response to natural selection. Okay, so here, change in the specific character, what does that mean? So here, changes in the specific character means the modifications which takes place in an organism, either in the cell or else some modifications in their body design. So it will take place. Why these modifications? Because an organism which is present, it will be having an habitat. When the habitat alli organism irutte. So environmental inaru changes adre. If any changes takes place in that environment, then the organism must adjust to that environment, right? And for that sake, the organisms must undergo modifications. Okay? The organisms, they must undergo modifications. So this is what a change in the specific character means. And the several generations, what does this mean? So here, several generations is like the evolution, it is not a single step process. Evolution, it is not a single step process. In evolution, it is a gradual change, okay? Gradual change in characters takes place. For that, several generations are needed. not only for one or two generations, okay, evolution have been takes place and new organisms have been formed. It is not that. Evolution is it is not a single step process. It is a gradual process which takes place in a particular organism, which will lead to the formation of new species. Okay, and when the new species are formed, they must respond to the natural selection. The living organisms, the formation of new species, they must respond to the natural selection. So here, what is natural selection? As I said before, the organisms which are present in the environment, they must adjust to the surrounding habitat, right? When they adjust, of course, due to the modifications, they will adjust, right? And this, the nature will select the organisms. Okay, here the nature will select the organisms. That means nature will accept the organisms which shows certain modifications regarding the environment. Okay, and what are the modifications? Why is this necessary? Let us take an example. Okay, here an organism A is present, and this organism, it will produce the young ones like B and C. Okay, it will produce the young ones called B and C, and the further this B and C, they will produce the organisms called B, X and C. So here the B and C is a one group. Consider this as one group. Now here in the B, several generations will take place. Okay, several generations will take place, and further BX will be formed. It is one organism, one of the generation. Consider this as one of the generation. And the C organism which is present from several generation, further also the C is only produced. Here no modification will take place, whereas here the modification, okay, the modification will take place, that is BX. This BX organism has some modifications, okay. And now, the certain environment, consider these organisms will be present in a habitat, a specific environment, and A will be present in the environment, in the habitat, where 25 degrees Celsius temperature will be present. The temperature will be around 25 degrees Celsius, whereas in B, this generation, B and C generation, consider the environment is about 25 to 30 degrees Celsius, and these organisms, they will survive mostly. They will survive under 25 to 30 degrees Celsius, and that's okay for them. Now, as I said, several generation after B, X and C organisms, like it is one generation, and the time has been more over here. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಟೈಮ್ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಸೊ ಫಾರ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಸೇಕ್ ದ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ ಮೇ ರೈಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಗ್ಲೋಬಲ್ ವಾರ್ಮಿಂಗ್. ಆ ಎನ್ವಿರಾನ್ಮೆಂಟಲ್ಲಿ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಆಗಬಹುದು. ಓಕೆ, ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ 100 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಸೆಲ್ಸಿಯಸ್ ಆಗಿದೆ ಅಂದ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ನಾವು ದಿಸ್ ಬಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೀನ್ ಮಾಡಿಫೈಡ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸರ್ವೈವ್ ಅಂಡರ್ 100 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಸೆಲ್ಸಿಯಸ್. ಅಷ್ಟು ಮಾಡಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ಸ್ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗಿರುತ್ತೆ. ಬಟ್ ಹಿಯರ್ the modifications will not takes place. So the nature will select these organisms. As they can survive around 100 degrees Celsius, they may be further survive. But see, they can only survive under 25 to 30 degrees Celsius because no modifications will takes place and it will extinct. But BX will have a chance to survive. Nature will select this organism. Okay, so this is how the modification will result for the betterment of an organism to survive. So modifications, or else the variations, okay, variations or changes in the cells, or else the body design, is important for an organism to survive to the environment, to its environment. Okay, and the variations, I said variations, what are these variations? So To know the variations, let us discuss about the cell division. So during cell division, what happens? Okay, in the cell division, the first thing, the initial thing in the cell division is the DNA copying. Okay, the DNA which is present, it must copy, right? A Xerox copy or a duplicate, one the duplicate agat. Okay, during, after the DNA copying, the nucleus will divide, the cell division process, the nucleus will divide, further the cytoplasm will divide, right? But the initially the DNA copying will take place. While DNA copying, if there is any variations or else any errors, DNA copy agbekadre, if any errors takes place while DNA copying, it will lead to the variations. Variations in the design of that cell. So a cell ge ondu design irutte. So that will change. The functions will change. Right? It will form a new individual, a new cell, which is dissimilar to the parent, somewhat dissimilar to the parent, right? So this is called variation. Variation is due to the error during DNA copying. DNA, the genetic material, right? While DNA copying, error will take place, and this error will lead to the variation. Further variations will lead to the evolution. Okay, so this was about the variation. Then I said modifications, right? So where modifications will take place? Modification yalle agutte. Initially, the modification will take place in the cell structures. Okay, as I said, the while DNA mechanism, variations will take place. So initially, modification will take place in the cell structure, and this will lead to the change in the body design. Okay, change in the body design, and when the body design changes, the mode of nutrition will also changes, because an organism based on its body design, so it will consume the food, it will consume the source of food from the environment, so that is nutrition, right? So based on the body design, the mode of nutrition will also change. So here, modification is when these structures which are present, the cell structures, body design, mode of nutrition, they will undergo modification in an organism to adjust itself in surrounding environment. Let us take it as a conclusion. Okay, so evolution, as well as in the evolution, modifications, variations will take place. That is because the cell structure, body design, and mode of nutrition, they will undergo modification, okay, modification or variations in an organism to adjust itself in the surrounding environment. Okay, now what do you say? Evolution is related to classification, or else does classification of life forms is closely related to their evolution? So if it is the question, then yes. So consider your surrounding. You will find different type of organisms, right? So these organisms, they will accumulate the changes in their body design. So they have lot of accumulation. They have lot of accumulation of body designs in them. So if you see different type of animals, one is very much different to the another, and some are very similar, right? So this is because the accumulation of the body designs. So it will lead to the, why this accumulation of the body design is important means, it is because to survive, the organism, it will possess, the organisms are allowed to survive better. Okay, so this body, the variations or else the accumulation is body, accumulation of body design. So it is, this will allow the organisms to survive better. Okay, and all living organisms are identified and categorized on the basis of their body design in form and function, in form, appearance and function. Okay, So all living organisms are identified and categorized, right? You will identify an organism based on their appearance, like it is dog, cat, rat, right? And this is because like they have different body designs. Their body designs are different in form and function. It is because when evolution takes place, okay, evolution aagbekadre, consider an individual is going to evolve. So it will form a new species which have a character, okay, some specific character, and this character, on the basis of this character, further characteristics are evolved. Further, any characteristics bandru, it is based on the characteristics which are initially formed during evolution. So here the character which come initially, okay, which will come initially, they are more basic compared to the organisms which will arrive later, okay. So here the initial characters are the fundamental characters of an organism. So based on the fundamental characters, further in the evolution different characters will be formed, okay. And Charles Darwin, he was the first to describe the idea of evolution, okay. Charles Darwin, he was the first to describe the idea of evolution in 1859 in his book The Origin of Species. So in his book The Origin of Species, he described this idea of evolution. So Charles Darwin, okay. And as I said, the organisms have two characters. One is characters which are formed initially, and further characters are formed. And based on that, different groups are formed. The one group is our group of organisms which have ancient body design that have not changed very much. So ili changes jasti agodilla, and the organisms, they will have ancient body design. And also the another group is organisms, or else the group of organisms that have acquired their particular body design relatively and recently, okay. So here the changes have been taken place in those organisms. So here we can group the organisms based on this, whether they are changed or not, okay. And the first group, the first group of organism are called as primitive organisms, primitive or lower organisms, whereas the second group of organisms are called as advanced or higher organisms, okay. Advanced or higher organisms. So here two types of organisms can be distinguished based on whether they have changed or else their body design have been changed or not, okay. Now coming to the hierarchy of classification. So what is this hierarchy? So hierarchy of classification is a grouping. Classification is basically the grouping. Why this grouping of organisms is necessary? To study the organisms in the group, right? So here the first attempt of classification was done by Aristotle. He differentiated, or else he classified, the organisms into two groups. One is plants and animals. In the plants, he classified the organisms into three types. They are herb, shrub and tree. And animals, he classified into anima and anima. Okay, anima and anima. Anima means the organisms which have red blood. The pigment, the hemoglobin pigment, the red is responsible for red color blood, right? So he classified organisms, the animals, into two groups. One is organisms with red blood, and the another one is organisms with colorless blood. That means these organisms will not have the pigments, the hemoglobin pigments, the colorless white color blood, you can say that, okay. One is with red color and another one is colorless blood. So he classified the organisms into plants and animals, but this classification is not much suitable because in the plants there are different types. Some are unicellular, some are multicellular, right? So in the plants he grouped all the unicellular, the prokaryotics and some of the unicellular, eukaryotic unicellular organisms as well as some lower organisms in the plants. And in the animals, only based on the color of the blood, we cannot differentiate the organisms. Okay, based on the color of the blood, we cannot differentiate the organisms. And coming to the other members who have classified, like consider the Linnaeus in 1786. So his classification was two kingdom classification. He classified the organisms into Plantae and Animalia. That's it, Plantae and Animalia. But here in his classification, he included all, as I said before, like Aristotle, he included all the organisms, the prokaryotic, the unicellular, eukaryotic organisms in the Plantae. And another one is Animalia. So further came Arist and Haeckel in 1866, right? In 1866, Arist and Haeckel, they classified into three kingdom classification, okay? And that is Protista, Plantae and Animalia. But in the Protista, they also included the prokaryotics as well as the fungi, because here the prokaryotics are very much different and fungi, they have different reproductive mechanism, right? So here the tissue differentiation, either they are unicellular or multicellular, they have been not done. So there was lack of capability of tissue differentiation, okay, in this three kingdom classification. Further came the Copeland, okay, in 1956, Copeland, he classified into four kingdom classification. So here in the four kingdom classification, by using electron microscope, at that time microscope has been invented, okay, and by using the study with electron microscope, he showed that prokaryotic, they possess different nuclear structures, okay, prokaryotic, they possess different nuclear structure. That means they have different cell design compared to the eukaryotes. And further, he grouped Monera separately. Okay, he took Monera from the Protista. He separated the Monera and Protista. So now four kingdom classification. Now further came R.H. Whittaker. R.H. Whittaker in 1969, he classified the organisms into five kingdom classification. He separated the fungi from the Protista, but the Copeland, he didn't separated the fungi. But here, R.H. Whittaker, he separated the fungi because fungi is very much different than Monera and Protista. Fungi have different reproductive mechanism, okay? So now, the five kingdom classification which we are studying now. We are studying the classification done by R.H. Whittaker, okay? Five kingdom classification, Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. Later came Carl Woese. In 1990, he introduced the domain, okay? He introduced domain, like whether they are prokaryotes or eukaryotes. If they are prokaryotes, like in the Monera, he again subgrouped. One is Archaebacteria and Bacteria, okay? And further, in the eukaryotes, the Protista, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. Prokaryotes only, Archaebacteria and Eubacteria. Further, eukaryotes only, Protist, Fungi, Plantae and Animalia. So this was classification done by different biologists. So this many years they have classified the organisms, and now we are studying the five kingdom classification done by R.H. Whittaker. So classification is done by naming the subgroups at various levels. So classification martevi. So the ivagino five kingdoms classification, right? So kingdoms na classify martha hodru. ಬರೀ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿದರೆ ಸಾಕ? ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್ಮಲ್ಲೂ ಸಬ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಆಗಬೇಕು, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ದ ಸಬ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಬಿ ಡನ್ ಓವರ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಸೊ ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ಫರ್ದರ್ ದೆರ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ಸ್, ದ ವೇರಿಯಸ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡನ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್, ದಿಸ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕೆಟಗರೀಸ್, ಆರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಕಾಲ್ ಇಟ್ ಆಸ್ ರ್ಯಾಂಕ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್? ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಒನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್. ಸೊ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಫೈಲಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಫೈಲಮ್. ಫೈಲಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಗೇನ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ಸೊ ಕ್ಲಾಸಸ್ ಆರ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಆರ್ಡರ್ಸ್. ಆರ್ಡರ್ಸ್ ಡಿವೈಡೆಡ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ. ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಇನ್ ಟು ಜೀನಸ್. ಜೀನಸ್ ಇನ್ ಟು ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಷನ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಗೆಟ್ ಆನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್, ನಿಮಗೆ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಸಿಕ್ತು, ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ, ಓಕೆ, ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈ ಅಂದರೆ ಯು ಮಸ್ಟ್ ಗೋ ವಿತ್ ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್: ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್, ಫೈಲಮ್, ಕ್ಲಾಸ್, ಆರ್ಡರ್, ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ, ಜೀನಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್. ಸೊ ಇದೇ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಲ್ಲೇ ಬರಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಹೌ ಟು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್? ಸೊ ಈ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ನ ಹೇಗೆ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು? ಸೊ ವೈಲ್ ಐ ವಾಸ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿಯಿಂಗ್ ಇನ್ ಹೈ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್, ಮೈ ಟೀಚರ್ ಟಾಟ್ ಮೀ ಅ ಟ್ರಿಕ್ ಟು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್ ದಿಸ್. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ KPC ಆಫ್ GS. ಸೊ KPC ಆಫ್ GS. K ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್, P ಫೈಲಮ್, C ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. KPC ಆಫ್ OF, ಆರ್ಡರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಆಫ್, ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ GS, ಜೀನಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್, ಲೈಕ್ KPC ಆಫ್ GS ಅಂತ ನೆನ್ಪಿಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಸೊ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ರೈಟ್ ದ ಸೀಕ್ವೆನ್ಸ್ ಈಸಿಲಿ. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸೇ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈ ಆನ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಆನ್ ಸಮ್ ಫಂಡಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್ ಅನಿಮೇಲಿಯಾ. ಓಕೆ, ಕಿಂಗ್ಡಮ್ ಅನಿಮೇಲಿಯಾ, ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಮೂವ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಓನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ಪ್ಲಾಂಟ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಕೆನಾಟ್ ಮೂವ್, ವೇರ್ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಮೂವ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ಒನ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಲೋಕಮೋಷನ್. ಸೊ ಅನಿಮೇಲಿಯಾ. ಫರ್ದರ್ ಕಾರ್ಡೇಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ದ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ಅ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಬೋನ್, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಕಾರ್ಡೇಟ್ಸ್. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ನ ತಗೊಂಡು, ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈ, ಸೊ ಒಂದು ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ಇದೆ ಅಂತ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ತಗೊಳ್ಳಿ. ಆ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ನ ನಾವು ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು. ಸೊ ಆ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮಲ್ಲಿ ಫಂಡಮೆಂಟಲ್ ಕ್ಯಾರೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಏನಿದೆ, ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಮೂವ್, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ದೆಮ್ ಇನ್ ಅನಿಮೇಲಿಯಾ. ಫರ್ದರ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಬೋನ್, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ ವಿಲ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಬೋನ್, ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ಸ್, ಸೊ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ದೆಮ್ ಇನ್ ಕಾರ್ಡೇಟಾ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಫರ್ದರ್ ಆ ಕಾರ್ಡೇಟ್ ಏನು ಅನಿಮಲ್ ಇದೆ, ಸೊ ಇನ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಅನಿಮಲ್ ದ ಫರ್ ಆರ್ ಹೇರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್, ಆ್ಯಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ದ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ದ ಮೆಮರಿ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೇ ಆರ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮಲ್ಸ್. ಫರ್ದರ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮಲ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಾಲರ್ಡ್ ಬೋನ್. ಓಕೆ, ಕಾಲರ್ಡ್ ಬೋನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗ್ರಾಸ್ಪಿಂಗ್ ಫಿಂಗರ್ಸ್. ನಾವು ದಿಸ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಪ್ರೈಮೇಟ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫರ್ದರ್ ದ ಪ್ರೈಮೇಟ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಫ್ಯಾಟ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ತ್ರೀ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಲ್ ವಿಷನ್. ಓಕೆ, ತ್ರೀ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಲ್ ವಿಷನ್, ಸೊ ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಮಿಲಿ ಹೋಮೋನಿಡೇ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಹೋಮೋನಿಡೇ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಪ್ರೈಟ್ ಪೋಶ್ಚರ್, ಲೈಕ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಪೋಶ್ಚರ್, ಅಪ್ರೈಟ್ ಪೋಶ್ಚರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಬ್ರೇನ್. ಓಕೆ, ದೇ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಜೀನಸ್ ಹೋಮೋ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಮಿಂಗ್ ಟು ದ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್, ಸೊ ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಹೋಮೋ ದಿಸ್ ಮೆಂಬರ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಹೈ ಫೋರ್ಹೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಸ್ಕಲ್ ಬೋನ್, ಎ ಥಿನ್ ಸ್ಕಲ್ ಬೋನ್. ಸೊ ಇಫ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಗ್ರೂಪ್ ದೆಮ್ ಅಂಡರ್ ಸ್ಪೀಷೀಸ್ ಸೆಪಿಯನ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಹಿಯರ್ ದ ಹೋಮೋ ಸೆಪಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಲಿವಿಂಗ್ ಆರ್ಗ್ಯಾನಿಸಮ್ಸ್, ಆರ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಹ್ಯೂಮನ್ ಬೀಯಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಹೋಮೋ ಸೆಪಿಯನ್ಸ್. ಸೈಂಟಿಫಿಕಲಿ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಹೋಮೋ ಸೆಪಿಯನ್ಸ್. ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಮೂವ್ ಅನಿಮೇಲಿಯಾ, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ ಬೋನ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಕಾರ್ಡೆಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಹೇರ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ದ ಮೆಮರಿ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ದ ಮಿಲ್ಕ್ ಗ್ಲ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಾಲರ್ಡ್ ಬೋನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಅ ಗ್ರಾಸ್ಪಿಂಗ್ ಫಿಂಗರ್ಸ್, ರೈಟ್? ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೈಮೇಟ್ಸ್. ಅಗೇನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ರಿಲೇಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಫ್ಯಾಟ್ ಫೇಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ತ್ರೀ ಡೈಮೆನ್ಷನಲ್ ವಿಷನ್. ವಿ ಆರ್ ಹೋಮೋನಿಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಪ್ರೈಟ್ ಪೋಶ್ಚರ್, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ರೈಟ್? ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಪ್ರೈಟ್ ಪೋಶ್ಚರ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಬ್ರೇನ್, ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಹೋಮೋ, ಜೀನಸ್ ಹೋಮೋ. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಫೋರ್ಹೆಡ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆ್ಯಸ್ ಎ ಥಿನ್ ಸ್ಕಲ್ ಬೋನ್, ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸೆಪಿಯನ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಹೋಮೋ ಸೆಪಿಯನ್ಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಹೌ ದ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ಡನ್. ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ in the classification, species is the basic unit of classification. Okay, this is the basic unit where the organisms, they are very much similar to one another, and these organisms can breed and perpetuate. Perpetuate means to continue their race. These organisms, they can breed and perpetuate. This is the basic unit of classification, the sapience. Okay, and in the sapience, the organisms are very much similar and have very, very, very less differences. But if you consider kingdom and phylum, in this group, the more number of organisms will be present. They have very dissimilarities. The dissimilarities will be more compared to the organisms which are present in species. As the subgroups will become smaller, the similarities will be more and differences will be less. Okay, so this is the level, so this is the hierarchy of classification, this kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus and species, APC of GS. Okay, so this is the hierarchy of classification. Now, as I said before, here Homo sapiens. So here Homo sapiens, human beings are called as Homo sapiens. Here Homo sapiens is a binomial name, okay? And this naming is called as binomial nomenclature, okay? Nomenclature. Now, if you consider different type of organisms, they have binomial nomenclature. See, for pea plant, its binomial nomenclature is Picum sativum. Onion plant, alum sepa, mango plant, Mangifera indica, wheat plant, Trichum sativum, banyan tree, Ficus bengalensis. Okay, the plants. Now, coming to the animals, frog, Rana hectodactyla, Hexadactyla, cat, Felis domestica, dog, Canis familiaris, housefly, Musca domestica, and cobra, Naja naja. Right, so these are the binomial nomenclature. Now, why we need this binomial nomenclature? Why not the common names? We can use the common names, right? Why this difficult names as binomial nomenclature for this organisms or any organisms? So whatever the organisms, the identified organisms are present in the world, each species have their own binomial nomenclature. Okay, and why is there a need for scientific naming, so or else the systemic naming of living organisms? Ithara classification yak maadbeku, why they need the binomial nomenclature, why they need the systemic naming? So here it is because, for example, in the world there are different type of languages, right? Bere bere languages ide. In our locality, we speak Kannada, English, Hindi, Tamil, Telugu, Malayalam, right? There are so many languages, and here, due to these different languages, the common name will also differ. Kannadadalli, if you call a dog, if you call dog, dog anta tagondre, if you call nai anta Kannadadalli karitivi, hoda, and kutta. English will carry TV. So likewise, common name will differ due to the regional languages, but scientific name, the binomial name, will be same for whole world. Idi world ali biologist enirtare, they must study the binomial name. Ili enagutte andre different regions alli hodre, so common name kuda change agutte, hauda? So it will be difficult for biologist to study the organisms. For that sake, they will consider the binomial names. So the binomial names, the scientific names, they will further study. In the whole world, the scientific name is common for a species. When the species Homo sapiens, andre idi world alli scientific name Homo sapiens antane irutte, human beings ge. Okay, likewise, so systemic naming is important. Okay, and the systemic naming of classification or nomenclature we use today was introduced by Carl Linnaeus in 18th century. Carolus Linnaeus in 18th century. Okay, and what is scientific name? So definition toward scientific name. The scientific name of an organism is a result of process of classification, right? The process of classification which puts it along with the organisms it is most related to. Okay, organisms which is most related to classification maadi, classification nantara, we will put the organisms where the organisms will most related to, either to the genus or species. Okay, so that is classification. Here classification, it is the scientific name of an organism, is the result of the process of classification which put it along with the organism it is most related to. Okay, now there are some certain conventions are followed while writing the scientific name. Scientific name barivekadre, there are some conventions, there are some rules. So what are those? The scientific name of a genus begins with a capital letter. So scientific name, genus too, it must be capital letter. Whereas the scientific name of species begins with a small letter. Okay, genus name, the first letter in rate, it must be capital and species must be small. Okay, and when printed, the scientific name is given in italics. Okay, if in case you are using the laptops or any typing apparatus, then you must change the font size into italic. Okay, the scientific name matra, so you must change the font into italics. Whereas when handwritten, the genus and species name have to be underlined separately. Okay, separate agi underline maadbeku. So these are the rules to write the scientific names. Okay, so this was about today's class. So here today we had discussed about the relationship between classification and evolution, further the hierarchy of classification, right? So different categories: kingdom, phylum, class, order, family, genus, species, KPC of GS, remember that. Okay, so the order of classification, the hierarchy of classification, and also we had discussed about the nomenclature. So what is nomenclature, what is scientific name, right? So in the next class, let us discuss about the kingdoms, the five kingdoms: Monera, Protista, Fungi, Plantae, and Animalia. So given by R.H. Whittaker, right? So we will discuss these five kingdoms in the next class. Thank you.